Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Princeton University. And over there, that's the oldest building, NASA Hall. And first off, I just want to mention that I'm not associated with Princeton in any ways. I'm not faculty, I'm not a student here, and they didn't invite me to here. I just came here by myself to enjoy this wonderful place. And I'm very sorry that there's a construction over there. Hopefully it's not too bad. Yeah. But anyway, I want to tell you guys that a lot of colleges in the US here, they have students prepare math competitions for high school students. And at Princeton, they have that as well. So today I prepared two questions for you guys. So let's take a look. This is the first one that I have. You see, I came here prepared, I printed this out at home and I got here. But anyway, let me read the question for you guys. It says, let x and y be positive real solutions satisfying this equation. Log x squared plus log y squared is equal to log of x squared plus log of y squared. And log base what? Doesn't really matter because we're going to compute the maximum possible value for log of x, y, and then square. So go ahead and pause the video and try this. This is from their 2019 algebra test, and this is their logo. Done? Okay, I have another question, and I love this question a lot. First off, we have a quadratic function, x squared plus 4x plus 2, and then we will have an equation. Check this out, f of x is equal to 0. And when you solve this equation, we are going to get the biggest real solution and also the smallest real solution. We are going to let r be the difference between the biggest and also the smallest real solution of that equation. And once you find out what r is, r will be in the form of a to the power of p over q. And right here it says a is square free, meaning that it does not have any perfect square as a factor besides 1. So 4, 9, 16, 25, etc., they are not factors of a. And then pq are relatively prime. And they say that because we are going to compute a plus p plus q in this particular form with these conditions. So go ahead and try this right here as well. Done? Cool. All right. Unfortunately, I didn't bring my whiteboard with me. But you know what? I have this for you guys. Check this out. I got a solution. And for all the files, I will give you guys a link in the description, okay? All right. So for the log question, the answer is 16. And then for the f of x, that question is 35, right? And let me just show you guys the test here. It has 8 questions on this page. And then the questions at the end, man, yeah, these are pretty crazy. You guys can, you know, take a look and try it. And personally, I love solving math competition questions, but I cannot solve all of them. In fact, I can only solve some of them. And sometimes there are questions that I cannot even understand what the questions are asking. But whenever I can solve the question, I will be super, super happy. So that's just me. And you guys can tell me like how you are with like math competition questions. Do you like them? What your experience with them, etc., etc. And yeah, this is the test that I have for you guys for today. And of course, Princeton, there are so many well-known people, well-known famous mathematicians from here. And just to name a few, Albert Einstein, and John Nash from Beautiful Mind, and Andrew Wiles, the one who solves the Fermat's Last Theorem. And then recently, of course, we can talk about Professor Terence Tao and also Professor Poisson-Low. And there are plenty more. If you guys know more, of course, drop down your names in the comment down below. And if you happen to be a student here, let me know how you like it here. Yeah, this is just such a wonderful place. I'm so happy to be here just to take a look and breathe the air. So hopefully you guys all like this video today. I will solve the questions for you guys later on once I get back home, all right? So maybe I will take you guys a little bit closer just to have a better view with the building right here. Whew. Okay, bye.